A man who is covered with glory isn't observant enough to know he is covered with glory. He messed up with it and the glory was taken away. Who will die? Who will go? Who will be sent? Think about this. There was a town with one church, a church with one son. The son killed someone. They brought him to the court, and his father was the judge. His father gave out only fair judgment. Let's pause a little. If you were the one and you were the judge, sitting right there looking straight into your son's face, what would you have done? But he had to declare his judgment. He looked at the son, he looked at the congregation, and he said, "This is my sentence. You are now about to die. For anyone who has killed someone must be killed." After decreeing his justice, he saw some police who took the hands of his son. He came down, rushing towards them. He held their hands and they said, "Let me die. Free my son." He died instead of his son. You know, God would have made you a tree or a chicken, but there you have the grace. He made you a human. And this rings about Jesus coming into the world. He said, "Father, send me." He knew nothing about what we've done. He knew nothing about the sin we've committed, but he's willing to sacrifice his all, just like the judge. He is the judge, and the son is we. He wouldn't forsake his children. Can you do that? Can you die in replacement for your son? Can you die for your father, your mother, your siblings? Let's think it through. If your mother dies, you will only cry. But you cannot die with her. You cannot follow her to the grave. But there, Jesus came down to die for our sins. It is something we hear every day. It is something we keep saying. We keep celebrating. We keep saying Good Friday. We keep celebrating, celebrating, and celebrating every year. We are the ones that befitted him. We are the ones that planted that crown of thorns on his head. We are the ones that mixed that vinegar with gall, giving it to him to drink when he said it was thirsty. You know, he had the chance to talk. He had the chance to say, "I am innocent. Free me. I knew nothing about this." Pilate asked him, but what did he do? He kept shut. He swallowed his pride, not because he is guilty, but because of us all. He took the cross that was too huge to bear. The cross that isn't meant alone for one person to carry. He took it because of me, you, because of us. Only for the scripture to be fulfilled, to reconcile us back to our creator, constitution to be followed, to take back that glory we've lost and return it back to us. But what are we doing? What is it to celebrate that Christ has risen? Truly, he has been nailed to the cross. He resurrected. He didn't just die. That means there is a salvation for we Christians. There is a hope for us because Christ died and he rose again. Because the rocks was rent and the veil of the temple was rent in twain. But these things aren't just to celebrate. It isn't just to dining alone. Think through. Are you celebrating him or you are nailing him? Will he be happy right now that you are celebrating him? Or will he be mourning and crying that you are still nailing him on the cross? And his blood is still afresh, even though he died a long time. Today is a day to sober up. To think, am I nailing Christ? I am actually doing what is right. If you cannot die for anyone, think this through. There is a judge who has one son. Dear, he stood. He died instead